We are going to make a seriously spooky Halloween eye. Why not? Right? Or it could just be an eye. Doesn't even have to be Halloween. So you are going to want, I'm using a nice thick paper so that it'll absorb some water when I put it on there. And you're going to want something round, and you could have three different rounds, a small for the pupil, a medium for the iris, and a bigger one for the eyeball. So round things to trace, or you could just do the iris and the pupil, which is what I will be doing. And then you're going to want a pencil and a permanent black marker. You could grab some watercolors, or if you're using watercolor paper, you can just use Crayola marker and it will work just fine for what we're gonna do. So I'm gonna start out, I always start out with a permanent marker so you can see what I'm doing. You may not want to start out with a permanent marker. You may wanna start out with a pencil. That way if you mess up, you can erase. And I suppose if you wanted to go grab your kids, you totally could. And did I say a water cup and a paintbrush? Because I don't think I did. You need a water cup and a paintbrush as well. So I am going to try to center my plate as best as I can. Whoop. And then I will trace this plate as best as I can without moving the plate. If you're doing this with your kids, you'll probably need to hold the plate for them to let them trace, or you trace for them and then they do the rest. Okay, so here's the iris, and then this could be the pupil or this could be the pupil. Either way, it's whatever you think. That's a lot of pupil. Maybe I'll go this way. Okay, so now I am going to try my best to get that in the middle. It may not be since I can't see the other side very well. And then we'll trace this. Another reason, whoop, you want to trace with pencil is so that you can not mark on whatever you're using to trace. So now I can go back, trace that a little bit better. Now, you really want a permanent marker that works well. And I am super bad, guys, about putting my markers back in my bucket, even when they don't work. So, I don't know if I have a good Sharpie out here, guys. Okay, so next thing we're gonna do is I am going to thicken up this line best as I can. Even though those other Sharpies aren't very sharp, they might still work better than this one, huh? Okay, let's just see. Okay, and then what we're going to want to do is we want to kind of make a zigzag line coming from the center. Yeah, not so good. Coming from the center of the eye. Okay, note to self, these Sharpies go in the trash can as soon as this video is over. Now try really hard to keep your zigzags up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, and not reaching too far, so that they're not like diagonal zigzags. Oh my, what a bummer. Okay. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a thicker, or well, maybe go again, just one more time. Maybe if I slow my marker down, more ink will have time to come out. Then we're going to do the same thing around this edge. Definitely bigger zigzag. It doesn't have to even be like complete zigzag. And if your marker is not bold, like mine isn't, you really want to try to find it bold, almost like a new black Sharpie, so that those, it's just super intense, right? Okay, then we might even add some in here. I do want to put a shine in the eye here, like that. So this way it kind of brings the eye to life, right? Whoop! I always do that, pull it right out of the tape, don't I, guys? Okay. I'm adding just kind of a loose line. Remember, this is supposed to be a little bit creepy, right? Okay, so lots and lots of black going on right now, but it's gonna be colorful here in a moment, okay? I promise. All right, now, man, you know what? I might go back with my Crayola marker here in a bit. But not right now. Okay, so now we know that when we get tired, we start getting these veins, right? Kind of grow off our eyes. Now, technically, probably could curve these corners off because our eye is not a rectangle. So we could imply that this is more rounded, right? There we go. Okay, there. So we've got these veins going on. There we go. And there's really, like, just have fun with it. Super gentle. Flick those lines, different directions. Now, this is a creepy eye. Our veins are not so noticeable unless we're tired or they're irritated, right? Our eyes are irritated. That's when our veins get more noticeable. Okay, so there's that. Now I can take a red marker and really emphasize these veins. Okay. Now, if you are using watercolor paper, as we discussed, you can use your marker, use the side of the tip so that you make a nice thick line around your edges, just like that. And what we'll do is we can go over that marker with water. And if you're using a watercolor paper and a washable marker, then that red will blend and kind of become looking like it's watercolor paint, which is pretty cool. You can even do that inside your eye too. Okay. Add extra red if you need to. There we go. You don't have to trace all of these with red, or you can. Up to you. This is your art, and there's no wrong answer. Trust my process. Looking super cool, right? Okay, now. What if I had some on my edges like this. And if we use the side of the marker tip, it gives us a nice and much thicker line. Oh, you could put this eyeball like on a door. It's like somebody's watching. You could put it on the refrigerator or the snack cabinet. That'd be creepy to walk up to a snack cabinet and see a big old eyeball. You could even put it inside the snack cabinet and really kind of catch somebody by surprise, right? So I could do some of the green, and then I could overlap some blue in there. Just like that. Again, if this is watercolor paper, these colors will smear and kind of blend together if you want them to on your paper. Or you can actually use watercolor paint to do that. You can even throw a little bit of brown in there, kind of like hazel eyes, right? Brown and the green anyway. There we go. Okay, so I've got a water cup right here. And I have my paintbrush. Now, I'm not entirely sure that this is watercolor paper. I think it's more of just a nice thick paper, but it is blending. So I can go over this just like that. All right. Okay, Biggie. Arena. There we go. Being little silly willies back there. She's trying to dig herself somewhere to lay. Okay. Now, here we go. Kind of blend that in just a little. Come around. There we go. Kind of bring that on around just a little. All right. Okay, so now I can come in here, do the same thing. Look, too much water. It's kind of starting to bleed. Do the same thing with my brown. Bring that around just like that. Okay. Super lovely. Super lovely, my darlings. Super creepy. Creepy lovely. So cool though, right? So we just go right over that marker. Here we go. Or you could use watercolor paint. Now, I purposely want them to blend a little. I just don't want them to completely blend. So it's up to you how much you overlap your colors. And then we can go right here on this edge. Take care of the green. Just like that. Now again, if I wanted to, I could have used watercolors instead of marker. I even still could add a little bit, kind of fill in those white spots, especially since my green marker was not working the best. There we go. I could try a little bit of purple on the blue, kind of get an indigo. That's fun. And spots. Get it wet again. Get a little bit more purple. Oh yeah, super cool. There we go. Awesome. Okay. Now, if I wanted to, I could kind of go on top of these a little, but you don't have to. I think they're fine. Maybe just go over a couple here and there instead of everywhere. Kind of smear a little bit of that red around just a little. All right. Hopefully this looks a little creepy, right? Okay. Then I could use my black, because my Sharpie wasn't working real great. I could use my black Crayola marker. I wanted to wait till I was done with the water though, because I did not want to get water on this and mess it up. There we go. It's all colored in as pupil, so it looks nice and bold. Okay. Oh, yes. That looks super cool, super intense. I could even go around this edge, clean up this edge a little bit, make it look a little more intense like we were hoping for earlier. So I'm just using the side of that marker tip, going slow and steady. Go, kind of darken this up right in here. Zigzag that we made earlier. The Sharpie, remember, it didn't show up very good. I'll go back over that. Make that show up a little better. Oh, yeah. I like it. Okay. And then we can even kind of go over this a little bit better. All the way around the edge. Our black Crayola marker is working a little bit better than that Sharpie did. It's okay, just seen its days, right? Got some good use out of it. Did a lot of drawings, a lot of videos. Okay. Black lines back in there that we kind of had going around. Remember those? Now, if your paper's too wet, the Crayola marker will not work very good on top, and you'll have to wait for it to dry to use it. Oh my gosh, that looks so cool, guys. I really, really like it. Okay, I think I can add just a little bit of green back on there, right there on the edges. Not sure if it's showing up that well for you or not. I have to be careful, because otherwise I'll just wind up blending with all that black I just stuck on there, and it'll just look like super dark green. Ooh, if we had like a neon green or a lime green, that would look super cool. Awesome. Okay, so that, my friends, is my creepy eyeball. Can't color that corner these corners very well because they have tape on them, but we could get those corners colored in. Cleaned up. There we go. Or you could even cut them off, right? If your paper was big enough, you could actually make the whole round eyeball shape and then cut out, you know, all the background paper off so it's an actual circle and not a rectangle like mine. Oh my gosh, super cool, my friends. So thanks so much for doing a creepy, spooky eyeball with me. And actually, it looks pretty cool. I had a great time. I hope maybe you picked up on a little something different, a little something interesting. And I hope that you have a very wonderful week. And I cannot wait to do some more art with you.